This is what Dutch levels of cycling look like. In Cambridge, 1 in 3 commuters cycle to work. In most of England, it's less than 1 in 30. But high quality cycling provision like this route, which links Cambridge Station with homes and workplaces, is rare.
We know what kind of cycle routes people want, ones that keep them away from motor traffic. But where should we be building them?
A new tool, funded by the Department for Transport and led by the Centre for Diet and Activity Research at the University of Cambridge, is starting to answer the question of where we should build for cycling potential. Traditionally, tools for transport prediction and planning have focused on motorised transport and dealt poorly with walking and cycling. This is a particular problem for cycling because of the massive suppressed demand. However, looking at where the 1 in 30 are currently riding doesn't necessarily tell you where the potential for cycling growth is greatest.
The PCT, which is short for the Propensity to Cycle tool, is a freely available open source web tool that enables us to visualise cycling potential across the whole of England. It uses origin destination data to identify which trips could most easily switch to cycling based on trip distance and hilliness.
The PCT allows users to see where has the greatest cycling potential and where this could bring the biggest health benefits through increasing physical activity and environmental benefits through reducing car use. It brings together real data from the census on how people travel now with data on which trips could be cycled.
We've got 4 scenarios. Go Dutch, where we see what happens if people in England had the same likelihood to cycle commute trips as people do in the Netherlands. The e-bike scenario assumes that people also consider using e-bikes for longer and hillier trips. The 2 other scenarios are shorter term. One looks at the government target to double cycling by 2025, and another one looks at what would happen if women were just as likely to cycle as men are.
So for instance, in places where cycling is common, as many women cycle as men or more, but in England, 75% of cycle commutes are by men. Part of the project involved carrying out evidence reviews and data analysis, and these showed that it's really important to build high quality and direct routes to get women and older people on their bikes. High quality routes were important because our review found that women and older people have stronger preferences for separation from motor traffic. However, these routes also need to be direct because our analysis of Dutch and English travel survey data also shows that women and older people are less likely to cycle longer trips.
The team has developed the tool with input from a range of stakeholders to ensure it meets their needs. Today's event is in London, but the tool's also been tested in other parts of the country, including Liverpool, Manchester, Newcastle, Leicester and Tunbridge Wells.
We are working with Transport for Greater Manchester on a more advanced version. This new version uses data from the transport model on all the trips, not just commuting, within the Greater Manchester area.
What's really exciting is to help ease the burden on local authorities and transport planners in making the business case for cycling. It helps on a higher level scale when we're talking about a regional level to take a sort of macro view about which places have the greatest potential for cycling, where we should really be focusing some of our cycling investment.
The tool can be used to estimate cycling potential within areas, which can be used to plan residential cycling services, like cycle parking and cycle hire. It could also be used to prioritise area-based measures to support cycling, such as reducing rat running on residential streets. Perhaps even more exciting, the tool can be used to estimate cycling potential along specific routes. It can show both straight lines and allocate flows to routes, mapping cycling potential onto the road network.
The model creates a vision of what high cycling England could look like. This allows us to see the potential spatial distribution of cycling in a way traditional transport models don't.
If we achieved Dutch cycling propensities in England, there would be impressive social, environmental and health benefits. The PCT should help ensure our investment in cycling is effective and can realise these benefits.